In the news today, from the strange news that the
so damn disrespectable. Is there talk out there of charging her with perjury? Is there charges now possibly looming of Michael Jackson getting his day in court against this family, against this prosecutor, against these witnesses who have come in here and possibly perjured themselves?
Well, so far we haven't heard any talk of perjury. This is going to be interesting on the part of the district attorney. Is he going to turn around and prosecute his own witnesses for lying on the stand?
This is a very important question, by the way. That's a very key question.
And we've had a lot of that. We've had a lot of people admit, I mean, one woman who used to work at Neverland actually said on the stand, she said, well, okay, I lied about everything. But we're not even allowed, because of the gag order that's in place, we're not allowed to ask any questions.
You've been out there questioning this case from the beginning when it wasn't popular to question it. You've been raising all sorts of questions about this family when it seemed like they were so innocent and Michael Jackson was the freak. Do you feel a little vindication now as we get towards this finish line? Lord help us if Snedden finally wraps up his case before there's no case at all left to be wrapped up?
I do, because I feel that about a year and a half ago, I was told the entire story by people who really knew it. And I have to say that I've not been surprised once. Every single person has come through exactly as described, which makes me really think that there is no case more than ever. Do I know whether Michael Jackson's molested children in the past? I have no idea. Is it possible? Sure. But in this particular case, with this particular family, I feel that a real mistake was made. You know, the Santa Barbara District Attorney's been waiting since 1993 to get someone in here that they can use to convict Michael Jackson.
What is the repercussions of a judicial system where you can have a prosecutor going through a grand jury, bringing these charges in like this, dragging this name, Michael Jackson, through the mud like this, people assuming he did it, people saying, well, if somebody in court is saying it, it must be true. Where does he go to get his good name back?
Snedden took a position on Friday in court where he sat behind the other prosecutors during her questioning, in very full view of the jury, looked disgusted. This is his witness. This is the person that he brought this whole case on. And now it looks like he's backing away from her. It was very bad.
Well, she's probably deviated from the script.
She can't memorize a script. That was a great moment when she said, I'm not a good actress. And Mesro said to her, you're a fine actress. Well, she almost never addresses Mesro in response to a question. When he asks her a question, she turns to the jury and then proceeds to give a long, digressive answer. The jury stares at her in disbelief. Sometimes she's actually addressed us, the press, in the back of the room. We laugh about it, but, you know, this is a question.
No, it's scary because they're very serious charges, and there's nothing worse in this country than being accused of molesting young boys. And what they have done here is very serious, Roger. And I think Sned knew the case was weak going into it. I swear I think he did, and I hope the jury gives him hell on that verdict day, and they come out there and saying, why was this case brought? Roger Friedman will be one of the good guys on that day. We've got to cut. We're in a time break, but I do appreciate you coming in.
Matt, thank you.
Now an NBC News exclusive from the Michael Jackson trial. Documents that show how the accuser's mother may have committed perjury and fraud over a period of nearly 2 years.
The mother, who is still on the stand, is either a key witness in what the prosecution calls the Jackson-led conspiracy before the molestation of her son, or, as the defense claims, is the architect of a shakedown aimed at Jackson himself. The defense case is that perjury and fraud are part of her history. When the mother of Jackson's accuser took the Fifth Amendment rather than testify about her welfare history, even the prosecutor said she may have committed perjury in certain of her applications. NBC News has had an exclusive look at those applications for welfare and food stamps. Documents that show the mother claimed she had virtually no assets after she'd received a six-figure court settlement and tens of thousands in donations for her cancer patient's son. On November 5, 2001, the mother's lawyer distributed over $100,000 from JCPenney's and Tower Records, whose security guards, she claimed in a lawsuit, had beaten and sexually assaulted her. The guards denied it, after her older son had been caught with clothes that hadn't been paid for. At least $32,000 of that settlement money was deposited in one bank account, with separate interest-bearing trusts set up for each of her sons. Yet 10 days after the payout, she said in her welfare applications, under penalty of perjury, that she and her children had no money from any source, no court settlements, no bank accounts, no interest income. She also said they had no health insurance, though her ex-husband's policy was and remains in force. In monthly eligibility reports and in a reapplication in October of 2002, the accuser's mother reaffirmed those answers and collected benefits until March 2003.
Just because she lied on her welfare fraud welfare application doesn't mean that she's lied in this trial.
But a Jackson lawyer who's not part of the singer's trial defense has formally asked the Los Angeles District Attorney to investigate the accuser's mother.
That's full-on fraud, but more importantly than fraud, in my opinion, that's full-on perjury.
Now, prosecutors are relying on the accuser's mother for detailed testimony about the surveillance and alleged death threats she says the Jackson camp used to try and control and intimidate her family, and she denies repeatedly that she ever wants any money from Jackson.
I first interviewed him when he was, I guess, 10 or 11 years old. I saw him at RFK stadiums. Then when he went on trial in 2005, I had overheard a conversation at Nate Now's restaurant here in Beverly Hills at the next table, and then the conversation dwelt over to our table, in which a lawyer was saying that the people who were pressing charges against Michael Jackson were, in fact, extorting from him. So I had told this to people, and they subpoenaed me to come and appear at the Jackson trial, and before I appeared, there was a hearing, and the judge did not allow me to testify because it was all hearsay. I was saying what someone else told me. I understood that completely. So did Michael. He gave me a nice smile on the way out.
Gavin was arrested for shoplifting at a JCPenney. When a security guard confronted him in the parking lot, they got into an altercation, and Janet Arvizo was arrested. Some weeks later, Janet Arvizo sued JCPenney, claiming she was sexually molested by the JCPenney security guards.
She was arrested, brought to the police station. We obtained the booking information where she said she didn't have any need for medical attention, didn't have any injuries. We also obtained the booking photos where you didn't see a bruise on her body or a hair out of place.
Docket tonight, an Abrams Report exclusive becomes a crucial piece of evidence in the Michael Jackson case. It relates to a secretly recorded audio tape of the mother of Michael Jackson's accuser right before the Department of Children and Family Services interviewed the accuser's family. This, at the very same time prosecutors say the family was effectively imprisoned at Neverland. The mother says the man you hear on this tape forced her to record the meeting.
Okay. All right. We're suspicious. I'm just going to put it here.
Okay.
A place to put it. Where
okay.
That can be in there. You don't have to keep talking to where it works.
Okay.
I don't know what you want.
Okay, I'm going to put it right here.
Dan, everything about this woman says Michael is innocent.